Once you reach the Bronze Age, you will unlock a ship that takes the name of Karve. So, it's a good idea to build for it a proper dock. This way, you can park it in a safe spot and easily get to the ground when you reach your base. The structure you will build following this tutorial is roofed, so it won't rot during the rain. Also, at the external side, you will find some ladders to get up to the platform in case you will fall in the water. Another pair of ladders can be found in the corners of the lateral piers. At the end of which, you will find a staircase with two portals. One can be linked to your mine base and the second with any location you are farming. While all the way up, you will build two cart parking slots. This way, once you get back from your travels, you can easily transport all the farming goods back to your mine base. While between the staircase and the parking slot, there is a ladder going down, where you will find a small temporary storage you can use in order to host some items you can transport later on. Under the parking slot, there is also a hidden room with a ward that will alert you if any structure gets attacked and prevent other players from building something else in this location. Plus, you will have here also a workbench and a forge to repair and build other structures in this location. So, let's start building this cool port. First, get to any shore, where using normal wood walls, start building a wall from where the water touches the ground. The wall must be made by 6 pieces that you have to extend with another level. To the top snapping point of each wall, you have to attach 3 rows of wood floors. Then connect the external one to the ground thanks to some stairs. A little note, even if it touches the ground with one stair, like in my case, extend it furthermore to even pierce the ground. This is needed to get easily on the platform with the cart. Using some 45 degree and half walls, close the hole between the stairs and the ground. Connect also the floors with the ground using normal walls on both sides and in between the stairs. Now, using a carve or a raft, get in front of the platform from the seaside. From where, build on top of each corner a floor, from where make go down along the wall some stairs going inward. Connect both stairs with some floors and extend a new staircase going towards the sea this time. To finish the stairs, place another set of platforms and stairs going out along the wall. Now get at the end of the staircase in order to see the main wall snapping points. You need to connect where the wall starts a floor. To do so, extend from the middle a half wall to be used as a snapping point to place the floor in the middle of this wall. After you remove the temporary wall you placed and extended the floor as well to the stairs, you will notice that it will end exactly at the stairs level. Now, on the other side, take out some 45 degree wall you need to attach to the internal side staircase and extend it using the half and normal walls all the way down to the floor you have to extend from the platform you built previously. Don't forget to cover the platform hole you just made on both sides on the platform extensions. Once done on both sides, use this section for 2 portals. Time to extend from the external side of the floating floor the half wall to match the level of the water and the mine platform. Then you need to take out the hole tool and raise the ground along this wall. Next, start extending the pier above the water and connect it with the ground using the hot tool till you will add extra 6 platforms. Keep in mind that it's really important that any single half wall will touch the ground and they will have the blue outline color. Otherwise, when we will build the roof, you won't have enough stability to finish it. Anyway, once you do the same to extend the other side as well, cover the section between the lower staircase and use a bolt to get between the 2 piers you just built. In order to see the snapping points that you now need to use in order to cover the floor on the internal side of the piers with the half walls. Now add the ladders at the end of the piers to be used to get out of the water if you fall down from the boat. As a bonus, if you want, add them also at the end of the pier to avoid swimming around if you fall not far from the staircase. At this point, extend from the bottom side of the frontal foundation a log pole that you need to extend from each half wall snapping point. While doing so, extend a small log beam from the top side of the previous log poles. That will allow you to place the new log pole easier, and it will be used later on for decoration purposes. Repeat this process on the wall external part of the pier. Do the same work on the other side. Then extend each log pole by another 4 meters. Now you can build the roof, starting from placing the 26 degree beams from the top of each log pole, rotated towards the inner part of the structure. At this point, extend a ladder attached to the log beam in order to place between them the roof, from which you need to place the 45 degree one on one side and extend the 45 degree beam as their support. Next, you have to get on the other side in order to extend them with another 45 degree roofs and support beams. The next step is to connect these new roofs with the one you're on top of with a series of 45 degree roofs and beams as on the other side. For decorative purposes, for the internal side of the structure, connect each beam between them with the normal one. Another decorative addition is to use the 45 degree beam to connect the top side of the log poles, rotating them every time. Once you repeat this for each pole, the main roof is done, so you can remove the ladders used to build it. Time to extend the lower side of the roof on top of the platform and even on top of the stairs. While doing so, attach the log poles between the platform and the roof as a support. To maximize the support power, extend the poles all the way to the ground. Once you do this, also on the other side, it's time to build the same thatch roof opposite to the one you just built. Using the 45 degree one, build another roof section on top of the platform till the end. This part has to stop before the stairs. Next, build the beams as support and decoration on each roof snapping point, and extend the log poles from the edges of the new roof section. Get on top of the new roof thanks to a ladder you can attach to it. Once here, to make the hole between the roofs cooler, extend the lower roof with the 26 degree beams, and build in the middle of each hole the 2 and 1 meter poles. Once done, don't forget to remove the ladders you used to get on top of the roof. Now use the wood beams to decorate each floor and wall connection in the main platform and the same in the pier dock. Now on each corner add the torches to illuminate the wall location. Back to the pier side, decorate the holes on the bottom side with the 26 degree beams, flipping them each time. Next part is to use the 1 meter wood poles and the beams to create the railings for the staircase. Do the same for the external part of the platform, all the way till the end of the staircase. And make the railings also for the internal part of the staircase as well. Now it's time to park two cars at the entrance side of the platform. Separate them, building a railing between them, all the way till the second floor line, along which you need to place the 4 meter railings as well. Then destroy the floor between this railing and the one for the staircase, and extend down a pair of ladders for both sides. Next, connect the bottom side with the floors, that you need to extend by 3 lines. This way you will create room under the cart parking, and don't forget to cover the ladder side with the walls. In the end of this section, place a workbench required to repair any part in case it takes some damage, a forge to build some sconces if needed, and in the middle a ward to alert you in case the structure gets attacked and prevent other player from building around it. Then hide this underground section with some walls. Hide also the area near the ladder, this way you will have a small section to fill with the chest you will use as a temporary storage between several farming expeditions. In this area you can place 5 chests on the bottom side, and thanks to some small floors you can add another line of 5 chests on top of them. At this point, add more sconces and torches where you see fit in order to highlight better the area. Once done, this structure is ready and you can start to use it for your ships.